whenever you've got two very good quarterbacks, both of whom have started, some people like to refer to it as a controversy, but that's not what it is here. You've got two very good guys, both of whom are probably going to play at some point during the season, vying for the starting position.
The old adage is that if you have two quarterbacks, you don't have any. And I think that couldn't be further from the truth here. Day by day, we're figuring out, you know, each of their strengths because things change, right? Their experiences have changed dramatically from a year ago. Both Malik and Deshaun, all those guys to have a chance to step into new roles and to bring different skill sets and different experiences to the table. You know, I think all of us are learning more and more about them every single day, and that's a good thing.
In my experience, usually when you have a quarterback competition like this, the two quarterbacks are different, sometimes very different. But really, right now, the skill set of these two guys is very similar. Talk to me about the positives about having that situation.
I think it's a good thing because we found last year when Malik's injury happened, we didn't know a ton about Deshaun from the standpoint of putting him out there with the lights on, with the cameras rolling and everything of that nature. And I think we saw that we didn't have to full sail change our offense. Now we evolved offensively, and I think that's been part of working through spring ball and fall camp is to figure out as the offense evolved to essentially fit a little bit more of Deshaun's skill sets. How can we also continue that evolution that would have happened had Malik played for the entire season?
You was one of the up-and-coming young offensive coaches in the country, Mike Denbrock and Brian Kelly. You all work very closely together on that game plan, and I'm not sure there are many schools that have three guys collaborating to the degree that you do each and every week.
Yeah, I believe that what we have here is very unique, and I think it starts with respect. It's respect for each other, and not just respect for everything that they've done in their careers. For me, looking at Mike Denbrock and what he's done, and obviously Coach Kelly and his track record, it also comes down to respecting their knowledge of the game and their experiences within the game of football and what that lends itself to. And I think that the same holds true for me. Me being kind of the new guy in terms of this offensive system, being Coach Kelly and something that my Coach Denbrock's been in a whole heck of a lot longer than I have. They also respect the ability for me to have ideas and to bounce those off of them and to see how they fit into the whole game plan.
As we wrap this up, the work of training camp really is just the beginning. What do you need to see from your quarterbacks between now and that first game?
There's one thing that we can get out of training camp at the quarterback position. It's going to be being on the same page with those wide receivers, because the thing that's so exciting about them is they're young, but they're so stinking talented. So it's an exciting opportunity to be a part of a growth coming together between the offensive unit. And I think we're in the process of doing that, but we got a ways to go.
Mike, thanks so much for taking the time.
Absolutely. Thanks, Jack.
I'm Jack Nolan, reminding you this training camp interview is brought to you by our friends at St. Joseph Health System.